You must write your own acting script to a TV show you create, direct, and star in it all by yourself.
I should be in charge of everything, so we are doing Baddies West.
Let's just get on with it.
Let's take a look at your little Baddies Mansion TV show.
That's why you're a faggot. Faggot.
What in tarnation is going on here?
Oh, I'm in real life. I will kill you.
You kid is like baby daddy. Oh,
God. Azura.
You can get outshined, and that's unfortunately what I think happened tonight.
Kylie Quinn.
Kind of lucked. Sort of like a punch.
Kamaria. I loved watching you. It was so entertaining.
No, because what you're not going to do is bring up my fucking career and my personal life. You have absolutely no room to fucking talk when I got good critique for my performance.
Kamaria. Congratulations, my dear. You are the winner of this week's challenge. Azura and Kylie Quinn. I am sorry, my dears, but you are up for elimination. Azura. Shantae, you stay. Kylie Quinn. Sashay, away.
Oh my gosh!
Well, wasn't that a lip sync?
What the fuck just happened?
As we walk back into the workroom after the elimination, I'm kind of shocked that I didn't win week two, but I'm not really finna make a big scene about it, even though I had the best critiques. So yeah.
What's the lip sync message?
This is a cunt. Go home. XOXO, rooting for all of you, except Maz and Azura. Well, nobody's rooting for you, sweetie, so have fun.
She just got eliminated. Look where that got her.
Now I have many a feelings towards many a people in this competition. Whether that's, you know, trying to be the center of attention or just being plain annoying.
Now, we need to run to the couch. Let's get out of here.
Let's not talk about the events on the stage today.
None of that happened.
So, do you want to talk about that drama that happened, Moss?
You know, she said what she needed to say. She had her little moment.
But and then she has got eliminated.
She said she was going to send me home. And look where that got her.
I mean, she said what she said. And half of that stuff was right. Like, compared to her, it's kind of sad.
And what was right, if you don't mind me asking?
Oh, the catalog.
The catalog, the one catalog, Boa.
Not just that.
It was just that.
So, Matty, how did it feel to be saved for the second time in a row?
Oh my god. It feels like shit, Eureka. Let me tell you. It was not good, honestly.
I thought you just felt safe, you know.
Yeah, you know about being safe, right?
Well, not from week one, but do you definitely do, right? From week one.
So anyways, I was gonna talk about my win.
Yes, congratulations, Kamaria.
Thank you.
She did very well. You did amazing.
Congrats, Cam.
And your look is gorgeous too. You look amazing.
Oh, thank you. I had help from Soy to make this.
Y'all should have seen the original concept. My eyes were bleeding.
Personally, I feel scared.
Well, personally, it's more space for all of us, so who cares?
And I hope Cam's look. Like, what kind of mother am I? A really good one.
Y'all, my feet hurt. This big-ass TV on my head is hurting.
I don't even have a waist or legs. Stop yapping, bitch.
Does she even have limbs? I don't think she has a single limb in her body.
I have, like, what? Six arms?
The winner of Verx's Drag Race Season 1 will receive a cash tip of 1,000 Robux, a month subscription of Discord Nitro, and sickening jewels provided by Bordeaux Media.
Drag race.
It's another day in the basement.
I like how we're all just saying that. It's a new day in the workroom.
It's a new day in the workroom.
A new day in the workroom.
It's a new day in the soy sauce meet and greet.
It's officially a new week in the workroom, and I'm very excited. I don't know what's going to happen, and, you know, I just hope, you know, it gets better from here.
What do you guys think today we're going to be doing?
Hopefully, something good. I want to redeem myself from last week's.
I want to do snatch game as well.
What's with everybody doing snatch?
I don't know what that is. Wait, what's a snatch game? I don't know what a snatch or a game is.
Literally, we just did characters last week, and you guys want to do snatch game?
Control. Yeah, I want to be Jennifer Coolidge.
You guys are unfunny. I don't like. Nobody cares about your snatch game. Nobody wants it.
Anyways. Pound the alarm!
Guys, hear my ears. Verx has to go to the red door.
Oh my fucking god!
Hello, my top seven. Welcome to week three. We are officially in mid-competition, which means it will only get harder from now on. You know what they say: when the weak fall away, the true talent shines brighter. So for this week's maxi challenge, you will be paying homage to the queer icon Kim Petras.
That's my Twitter oomph. They follow me on my Twitter account.
That's my Twitter oomph too.
I do not listen to Kim Petras, even though I know some songs from her. I don't even know if they're from her. I just know it's a song and that's the artist, but I don't listen to her. So I don't know how I feel about this week.
We are doing Kim Petras Rusical. Are you kidding me? She's my favorite.
I don't know who that is, but we're...
Slut Pop, the sluttiest album ever made. It has been a queer classic since release. For this challenge, each of you will be given a track from the album, and you will have to perform it on the first ever musical of Verx's Drag Race, Kim Petras, the Unauthorized Musical. Kamaria, since you won last week's challenge, you will assign the tracks to your fellow competitors. It is up to you to sabotage or play it congenial. I was feeling a little needy this week, so on the runway, category is 1,000 Nights of Verx Bordeaux. You can either use one of my old drag looks or do something that fits my aesthetic. Artists, start your engines and make the best road drag queen win.
I'm not that gay like the rest of y'all.
So this week we're doing the Kim Petras Rusical, and you know, I'm excited for it. I am a fan of hers and I listen to some of her music, and you know, I think I'm gonna do good. I'm just worried about some other girls and how they'll do, but I know for sure I'm going to do good. So, yeah, I'm not worried at all.
Okay, so, like, do everybody want a specific role or anything? Or,
I don't know this artist.
I guess for me, my top three choices would be Slut Pop, XXX, and Super Power Bitch. Those are, like, the main three that I want.
Okay, so, who wants Slut Pop?
Crickets.
The way no one wanted to do Slap Up, and literally Slap Up being the first song, the best song, I would have done Slap Up, but it's the first song, and I don't want to go first.
I mean, Kamaria, you were my baby mother, but please do not give me Slap Up.
Oh, well, you're getting it. Oh, Slap Up goes to Soraya.
Alright, come on. I see you.
Cam, that was so shady.
I'll get treat me like a slut. Anybody want XXX?
I kinda do.
No, girl, I want it first. I said it first. That's mine.
So, doesn't matter if you said it first or not. It's not like you're gonna do any better at it.
It's not like you're gonna know any of the songs either way.
Girl, this is the only song that I know and I actually heard on TikTok.
Okay, well, you should expand your taste level a little bit. You need to listen to more music, sweetie.
Having to listen to music doesn't mean that I can't outdo it. Like, girl.
I can still outdo you, so I don't know.
You can outdo me? Weren't you, like, in the bottom? Girl,
wasn't that about acting, not lip syncing? Like, I did lip syncing. This is like lip syncing challenge, technically.
I mean, I kind of overheard you saying that you don't know how to lip sync, and Moss is gonna let you some moves. So you shouldn't be really talking about lip syncing. Why are we stuttering? Let's not forget how you hit the stage real hard when you were lip syncing.
That was my computer. Sorry that my computer isn't $5,000. I don't have a.
Oh, are you saying you weigh like the computer then? Because I didn't see your computer.
Yeah, it's like, yeah.
But you know what? Since you want it, I guess I'll give it to you because you're in desperate needs. And plus, it fits you because it's 3X and you're like, what? A 3X?
Oh, you're also like a 5X. So, that doesn't really mean anything.
I mean, from a person who's literally a pet. Anywho,
she's in control. Also an animal. I don't know what you're talking about. Anyways, thank you. I guess I get my song.
Girl, I know that I could have done more than what she can. Like, girl, wasn't she just in the bottom last week? And she's over here attacking me that she's gonna do way better. Okay, we'll see about that.
All right. So it goes to Azura. Who wants superpowers?
Me. I'm so into you know superheroes right now. So I would love to get superpower, bitch.
All right. So superpower bitch goes to Maddie. Anybody wants throw goat?
Does anybody know if this song sounds good? Does the song sound good?
Well, I think you should go to you because you know you're a hip hop right now. So,
you're making me blush.
It's gonna go to you. So yeah, you'll get that.
Okay.
I don't know what goat throat means, but I just know I have a good throat and I'm built like a goat, so I'll be fine.
Anybody want to fuck?
I do. I'll take that one.
Of course it's the girl who played the Holy Fans.
Yeah! I'm being different.
Different? So you're staying to this
different. Being different. No, I'm actually not being different. That's
of course it's the one who stole my idea.
Then Ryan, nobody stole your idea. You were the one who stole the idea.
Ryan.
No, I didn't know.
Sanraya.
Someone's a little dyslexic.
Tomato.
But anyways, as I was saying before, I was really interrupted. That's the only song I know, so I'll gladly take it.
Of course, you know about interruption. Question.
Uh-huh. So your wish is my command. We'll go to Adrian. This is the last one.
Anyways, I think it is time for me to go and focus on my stuff. I don't want to go home anyways. It's
time for you to stop yapping.
Hell no.
Who is that? Oh my god.
Wow. Baby, you already know it's NYC, baby.
Please welcome Beach's alter ego, the one and only Cookie Puss NYC.
Happy Mother's Day. Okay, hi.
Hello, motherfucker.
It's so soon.
Miss Mama, Miss Wing, what do you think you're gonna do for the challenge?
Well, I mean, getting XXX was the song I wanted. And, like, I love Kim Petras. I love this album. This is my favorite album. With XXX, it's such a, like, fun song, but I feel like I want to do some kinky ass shit. Like, I want to go out, I want to do BDSM latex ass shit. Like, I want to just be as kinky as possible and just serve that.
Okay, so you want like the exclusive content piece of the Rusical Mama?
I just want to serve puss, that's all.
No, that's all. I can teach you how to serve puss. So, what you do is you gotta get Laganja Dip 1. Okay, she's really pissy.
Okay, Laganja. Oh, yeah. I love that. Alright. Let me also do Laganja. Let me also do that, you know? Oh, okay.
Okay. Okay, you almost did it as good as me. You almost.
I love that. That is true, Puss. I love that.
Now, I told you, I'm gonna teach you how to be Puss. But as a Rusical winner, I would say that the most important thing is that you're having fun and that you do the worm on the crowd. So what I did is whenever I was fucking up, I jumped into the crowd Puss first, and I wormed all across them. And guess what that did?
Oh, yes, I love that. You know what? I'll take that in mind. I know I'm probably going to make some errors, but honestly, with that advice, I might as well. I will just have fun. I will make sure not disappoint you and anybody else this week, because I already have been flopping, so let's not try to flop this week.
Baby, with the puss advice, you're about to win. Trust that.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We are going to serve puss. I cannot wait. Just let her get her little moment. Let her have her moment.
But that's all I'm at. I'm on the table. Hello, motherfucker! Okay, bitch. So, you know the challenge. It's giving slut pop. It's giving pepper pop, baby. It's giving puss gagaton for a puss. So what are you thinking about?
Okay. I genuinely, I want to be like stupid. I want to be a goat. I mean, I'm sticking to the name, Goat Throat, so yeah.
Oh mama, it's Goat Throat. You said Goat Throat.
Is it not that? Girl, I don't know her.
Well, is a lot of your drag, giving mammals or what's going on? Cause you're a hippo right now, but now you're about to be a goat.
Girl, it's called shape-shifting. We all do it. I mean, we just get into drag. You look very different from now. And then.
Baby, this is my real hair.
Can you give us a spin? Can you give us a spin?
Mama, I can do you one better. I was gonna keep this a secret for the other girl, but I forgot her name. So.
Who? The big one?
She kind of looks like...
I want
a rat. But basically, you have to dance, and then you go, meow, meow.
Okay.
That's how I win.
It's giving rat. Ben and Snap, Sudie. Ben and Snap.
If you do that move on stage, baby, you're bound to win.
But I'm not flexible. I don't even know if I have toes.
Oh, baby. No.
I mean, I have to look at you from the side because my eyeball's literally up the side.
ugly.
Oh, ugly. I'm not Moss or Miss Matthew.
I might be a dumbass, but all of y'all are dumbass.
Dumbass? Are you saying that's like this? Oh my god.
Oh. Be careful, there's water there! Okay.
Welcome to the main stage of Verx's Drag Race. She is the boss. It is Angela Galore, everybody. Hi, Angela. What is your favorite song on Slut Pop?
Hello, Bordeaux. I don't listen to Slut Pop, but I am a slut, so... I'm glad to be here. Thank you for inviting me.
It's my pleasure. She is the Brazilian icon. It is Katy Perry. Hi, Katy. Any advice for people who don't do it right?
Verx. Funny. They can start doing it right by start streaming my fucking album on YouTube. Please.
You have my vote on that. This week, I challenged my queens to perform in the Kim Petras Slut Pop The Unauthorized Musical, and on the runway, category is 1,000 Nights of Verx Bordeaux. Racers, start your engines and make the best drag queen win! Thank you.
Take it all, love it big or small, make it hit the wall. Them LA boys, they wanna fuck, they wanna fuck. Them New York boys, they wanna fuck, they wanna fuck. Them Euro boys, they wanna fuck, they wanna fuck. Them Dubai boys, they wanna fuck, they wanna fuck. Every time I look at my phone, got these boys trying to get in my zone. They don't wanna leave me alone, they just wanna fuck me through the phone. I don't wanna take you home, I just wanna pull up and get that done. Like, lick that ice cream off the cone. When I wake up, bitch, you better be gone. Them Christian boys, they wanna fuck, they wanna fuck. Them Tokyo boys, they wanna fuck, they wanna fuck. Them good old boys, they wanna fuck, they wanna fuck. Them crazy boys, they wanna fuck, they wanna fuck. I wanna fuck, I wanna fuck. I wanna fuck, I wanna fuck. Now I wanna fuck, fuck, fuck. I wanna fuck, fuck, fuck. I wanna fuck, fuck, fuck. I wanna fuck now.
Category is 1000 Nights of Verx Bordeaux, a look that fits my main aesthetic or a look inspired by one of my old looks.
For my runway, I decided to go for this Kylie Minogue blue showgirl outfit from Verx Bordeaux. Actually, she only wore it for her little server profile, so I decided to take that and recreate it into something better. Look at me, head to toe. I am sparkling like if I was the definition of glitter in sequins.
Tonight on the runway, I'm serving classic Verx from the red dress to the blonde wig to the white fur. But from head to toe, I feel nice, I feel beautiful, and I feel like that girl. And I hope the judges are loving what I'm serving them. And you know, go from here.
Tonight, I am giving you a black soul dress that is truly ending every generation. I have this cherry talk hair on with this new look of a body of mine because I took Ozempic. It's truly speed love. I don't know if this is a Verx enough outfit, but all I know is that I'm rising and I'm walking out this door feeling invincible.
Tonight on the runway, I'm presenting to you my vision of Verx Bordeaux and her showgirl moment, era, situation, etc, etc. This is not the type of look I would normally present, but you know, you gotta step out of the box every now and then. But who cares? I got a nose now, and I'm ready to the competition.
Welcome, queens. If I call your name, please step forward. Adriana Bang Bang. Ms. Maxine Mozzarella. Miss Maddie. Sanrea Swarovski. Soy Sauce. Azura. Queens, you represent the tops and bottoms of the week. Kamaria. You are safe to slay another day. You may untuck backstage.
Thank you.
Queens, it is now time for the judges' critiques. First up, Adriana.
I think you had, like, a little cute entrance moment with the shoe. It's a shame that most of it wasn't caught on camera. But definitely, I will say that your performance really didn't have any layers to it. Like, the box, when you jumped off of it, it didn't feel like a moment. And to me, when you have stunts like that, it should feel like it was a moment, like it was a part of the performance, and it didn't feel like that. And the tower thing was cute, but, like, again, it was just boring. Sorry.
It was cute. But I will say, you did fall behind. You know, it's a performance. I need you to outshine others. You were outshined. And on the runway tonight, although this is something, it's very basic. I was expecting more of you.
I totally agree. This week was not your week at all. Thank you, Adriana. Next up, Azura.
I think definitely your set was one of the best ones, for sure. I was so glad to see that somebody made like a full set. You had multiple reveals, which, you know, as someone who does a lot of reveals, I love to see reveals because it keeps me engaged. I think you did a good job at matching the vibe of the song with your look, which I feel like quite a few of the girls did not do. And I think also you had slow moments and fast moments, and I think that, you know, you interacted with your set really well. I thought it was a good performance. This runway, from the description that was given to me of this theme, I don't think that this is necessarily something that fits some stoning. Even though I don't do stoning, I think stoning definitely would have elevated this look a lot more than, you know, this like tar, like oil, like blob that you have going on here. Like, you know, you got some like drastic diarrhea on a dress.
Diarrhea? Girl.
Baby, the category was 1,000 Nights of Verx Bordeaux. You came out as Morticia Adams.
Morticia Adams? Girl.
I think this is gorgeous, but it isn't fitting for the theme at all.
Well, performance-wise, it was decent. It was okay. I will say it looked okay. The performance was okay. It could have been better, but it was okay. You weren't outshined, but I wish it was more.
Thank you, Azura. Next up, Ms. Maxine Mozzarella.
The performance, and oh my god, that set. You ate down, bitch. This week, you did it right! This look is gorgeous. Oh, honey, this is perfection. But I think it could have worked a little bit more on the bottom part.
This look is really cute for me. First of all, be careful with the stoning, because again, even though I don't stone a lot in that way specifically, I think the stoning like it's kind of floating off of the bottom a little bit, which is something that I struggle with as well. So definitely be careful with that. But I think that the silhouette of this gown is really cute. Moving on to your Rusical, I think that the set was cute. I think that definitely you had the best timing out of everybody. I think you definitely had the best timing when it came to like the lights and the words appearing in the speech bubbles and the lighting of the people appearing. Your timing was really, really impeccable. I think it was honestly like a really one of the best musical performances I've ever seen, honestly.
You always amaze me with how much effort you give to these challenges. Props to you for that. Also, this is the best you have ever looked on the runway since week one. Good job. Thank you, Moz. Next up, Sunraya Swarovski.
Your performance was okay, but it was a bit of a letdown. It was also a okay performance look, but you know, I wish it was more. You were truly outshined by a lot of people in this room. So let's move on to this look. It's very basic. And you know, you are in the film's launch. You're going to be seen from up, down, left, right, back, front. So you need to look good on all angles, and for that to look good, you need to get the details right.
I think definitely you and Adriana, you both went for very similar looks, and I don't think either of you really achieved whatever. Because first of all, with this look, you have a skirt, but why do you also have Spanx underneath them? Like black Spanx. I understand that it's a catalog outfit, but I think I would have definitely invested in choosing one that's not from Ross Dress for Less.
I really don't think you were prepared enough for this week. It is definitely a letdown.
Looking at Verx's face, I am definitely in the bottom.
Thank you, Sunraya. Next up, Miss Maddie.
If I did Showgirl and Soy Sauce was on the other end of the stage for me wearing what she's wearing tonight, I would have changed my concept. Sorry. Like, this does not give me Showgirl. It really does not.
Bitch, your performance was so funny. I loved it. And you know, the look was decent, but the performance paid it off. On the runway tonight, I will say you look really cute. Could have been more, but really cute.
Do I think your performance was the best? No, but it was definitely a standout from a few other queens, in my opinion. Thank you, Miss Maddie. Next up, Zoe Sauce.
Your performance was really entertaining to watch. It was very fun. You know, in road drag, it's kind of easy to watch a performance and be worried by the person performing, because you're like, oh, are you gonna manage to pull this off? But bitch, you did it. You pulled this off amazingly. On the runway tonight, best of the week by far. Let's talk about serving the look. Bitch, that's how you do it. Everyone on the runway tonight, take notes. This is how you do a good look.
First of all, you got Throat Goat, which, you know, that's probably one of the songs that I actually knew off of the set. I think the set was really good. I thought it was one of the better ones, definitely. I love the goat head. I will say there were a few moments where you kind of just like stopped doing moves and then you were just walking around. But with the exception of that, I felt, you know, it was pretty exceptional. Definitely a standout for being one of the better ones, but it was, you know, it was okay. As for this runway, however, I definitely think once again, you took a shit on these girls for real. Like, you are on their necks. Like, girl, let up, let them breathe.
Baby, you never miss on the runway. This is gorgeous. Like, I want to wear this hoe. Thank you, queens. While you untuck in the backstage, we will be listening to Katie sing.
This is the best day of my life.
You may leave the stage.
Oh my god.
I need to I need a seat.
Cam's right. Sitting alone in the untucked.
Emo.
What?
I was alone. I don't know what happened.
Too much happened. First off, I got called Miss Matty, so that's concerning. I don't think I look like her, but I guess I am Miss Matty, and I'm welcome back into the competition.
Miss Matty, welcome back to the competition.
Word. Well, I know I got good critiques. I don't know about the others. I was just listening to myself.
I got good critiques, and I'm happy with mine.
Anybody get anything better?
I don't agree with any of the
critiques. I got, I don't know from where in the hell I got back critiques because I look very good tonight. I don't know. I'm just.
Baby, you're wearing a Seattle costume. I don't think that's really good tonight.
I mean, I know for sure. I think Miss Carney Asara is definitely in the bottom. She really got called out.
No, I'm not in the bottom. My look is way better than like everybody else in the bottom.
Girl, you look like the painting in the back. What are you talking about?
Even if I got told I look like Morticia Adams, I still look gorgeous. So who gives a damn?
Anyways, well, I feel great because I was really nervous this week. So I'm happy that I was able to exceed my expectations. And yeah.
Wow. I see that you took the little idea that I gave you, I guess.
The wine bottle, yeah.
What kind of wine?
What?
What kind of wine is this, sweetie? Do you not know your wines?
It's Bordeaux brand wine, actually. Remember, like, when she said in week one that the judges, that she's gonna force her judges to drink her brand.
How do you know that if you were...
Because she said, all you ladies don't critique.
You weren't on the stage. We were all told to go untuck.
She said, while you ladies go untuck, I'm going to make my judges drink my wine.
I will force the judges to drink Bordeaux wine in my very secret casino basement. Wait, what?
Okay, but that wine is hidden, so where did you get it from?
I got it. I snuck in.
Oh. Production, disqualify her. Disqualify her. She's stealing from the host.
I'm making a look inspired by the host. I need it to be as accurate as possible.
So, Azura, did you talk to Miss Spooky Post NYC or whatever?
Uh-huh. I had no clue what her advice was, but I was like, "Yar, go, you sister."
It
was very confusing. It was like she was just saying shit, and she had like a voice tune on. Like I could imitate. She's like, "Yeah, so you gotta do this and you do that. Like, yeah, you gotta spread your piss like this." I was like, "Where's the advice? Where was the?"
Yeah, I was in the other side of the room, hearing all of it. How she was like, like kind of Cardi B, like.
No, she might as well be Cardi B. I love her though. I feel like. If we need a queen for season two, Miss Puss, Cookie Puss, New York City, let's bring her back for season two. I need to see her just murder the workroom.
I agree.
I mean, not to mention that she also tried to attack us.
What?
Bitch. Why am I getting dumb? What the fuck?
Bitch. I'm here full of thugs and hits, Mac. Dumb. Bitch.
Hit her!
Yeah.
I don't know who that was, but honestly, go her. Work.
I think that was...
What
did I say? Oh my god!
Okay, so she called me a rat or some type of animal, and then she began to chase me, and then she began chasing Soy because she thought that Soy said that she was ugly. What I actually said that she was ugly.
I think she confused you with.
Yeah, so she started chasing Soy and then she chased me and we were just running around the whole room. She was trying to murder us. She tried to drown me in the river. Kamaira, how do you feel after your performance in the Rusical?
I feel like I could have been, you know, high. I was a little gag and I was for now safe. But,
Yeah. Honestly, I think I would have swapped you with somebody else, but that's just me.
Who do you think they should have swapped me with?
Let me see. Honestly, off of my own opinions and also me believing I shouldn't be in the bottom this week. That's just me. I think I would have said Maddie. Like, Maddie, I'm not trying to say this as shade. I just think that you did really weak and yours was just very comedically held. You basically did comedy and that's what basically... carried you.
There's a saying that goes, delusion, convince yourself, and it totally applies to her.
Whereas like I feel like Kamaira definitely fit the song, and I thought I fit my song pretty well. That's just my opinion.
So you're saying that my comedy shouldn't be praised?
You were just spamming.
Shouldn't be praised.
You were literally spamming the adore sit move on the dildo that you made. I don't think that's really showing a performance, but I mean, whatever Verx says, I'm just agreeing with Verx.
I find it funny. The judges found it funny.
Judges are ugly.
I think even the most unserious person would find it funny.
I am very unserious. I didn't find it funny. That was me, but honestly.
Okay.
So you got XXX and still flop. Well, I got a song that I didn't even know and I ate.
Well, I don't think I should have been the bottom, but you know. Congratulations, I guess. Woohoo, you got another top placement. I'm not shocked. I didn't even know the artist. How fun. Woohoo.
I know, right? And I still ate. Especially coming from a person who listens to a lot of music. Like, I'm so done with this, like, argument, supposedly.
Well, you're the one that questioned, so go you.
Can we cut?
Another day, another chance of wanting to die each week. I love this long term.
I was being back here by myself. I was getting sleepy. Then y'all came stopping in the room with y'all big size B13s.
So I wear a size 15 in shoes, so I can understand why you heard us so quickly.
No, I heard a bunch, like, elephants cut something into the room, so I thought I was being attacked. Then I saw y'all, so I feel comfortable.
Why don't you do it right, like some other men do?
Thank you, Katie.
I love this.
I have made some decisions. Bring back my girls.
Hey, Verx, before you give placements, I want to say something.
What is it?
I have been attacked from Sunreya out of nowhere when I'm not even speaking, so she's kind of getting on my nerves. So I really hope
Where in the hell did you get the owl?
Entrances, untuck.
Babe, you been fucking rude with me all the time.
Episode 1.
You wanna say I am rude once again, once to you, and you wanna get it out.
Episode 1 untuck. I seated and I said nothing, and you started saying, "I'm just getting on my nerves," when I did not even say anything.
But you are. Because
if you really wanna pop the tea.
Don't make me, because I'll fucking beat your ass.
We both know that we're in the bottom. Pump our 1v1.
You know when Tyra and Tati were fighting in the main stage, and Tati goes, "Tyra is a complete bitch.
Tyra is a complete bitch."
This feels like that moment.
Like, you have been yapping backstage here in the workroom, in our talk, every fucking where you've been yapping all about, you know, stuff, and you literally get on my nerves, and I have to get it out, as you have to get it out now, in front of Verx, like, hello.
Like Candy Ho said, no veremos la tarifa.
Didn't understand that. Like, literally, leave me fucking alone. Please, Verx, do the placements. I can't with her.
Let's move on.
I'm having so much fun.
Queens, I have made some decisions. Ms. Maxine Mozzarella. This week, you wine pond us, girl. Miss Maddie. Welcome back into the competition. Soy sauce. Diamonds are shiny, so are you. Ms. Maxine Mozzarella. Congratulations, my dear. You are the winner of this week's challenge.
I was not expecting that!
I was feeling nervous, but you know what? I showed up and I'm proud of myself.
You have won a small cash prize of 50 Robux and a cute little photo shoot provided by Bordeaux Media.
Oh.
Maddie and Soy, you are both safe. Good job this week. All three of you may step to the back of the stage. I am sorry, my dears, but you represent the bottoms of the week. Adriana. It's time to stop relying on the lip-sync girl. Azura. More confidence and less. Morticia Adams. It's the key to your best version. Sonrea. Safe queens never make history. Give us more. Azura. You're safe.
Thank God.
Which means Adriana and Sunraya. I am sorry, my dears, but you are up for elimination.
Oh my fucking gosh. I didn't think this would happen.
So, Adriana is mad. Sunraya is mad. This lip sync, it better be mad too.
Two queens, stand before me. This is your last chance to impress me. And save yourself from elimination.
I'm a boy back here and I need some entertainment, so somebody need to shake some shit up, do something.
The time has come for you to lip sync for your life. Good luck. And don't fuck it up.
I met you one night on the corner of a bad decision. When my eyes locked with yours, it felt just like a fast collision. You roll your money up and you call that your true religion. Baby, I believed, thought that was only me. You know the walls, they talk, but I just didn't wanna listen. I was dumb enough to let go of my intuition.
Work, Eva.
Yeah.
Okay.
This is even better than a K-pop concert.
That was a lip sync.
This is a lip sync. I did not expect to see both of these girls sweep the floor so hard in the lip sync, but they really killed it.
Thank you, queens. That was an incredible lip sync. I have made my decision. Adriana. Shantae, you stay.
Thank you so much. Love you, girls. You did good.
Sunraya, my dear. Even if the sun refused to shine, you will still be a superstar. Now, sashay away.
Well, they got me again. Bye, y'all. Have a great experience without me.
We did pretty good.
We're gonna have no yapping for the rest of the season.
Well, I didn't think I would get eliminated this fast, and I'm truly gagged about this. I definitely think I got way too over in my head, and I got overshined by everyone. So, sometimes this could be an experience that I could learn something about me. So, it's always a good thing about me. Now it's time for me to pack and go, sadly, because I guess it wasn't my time. Anyways, I'm happy that I got everything sorted with Audrey before our lip sync, and I love her too because she helped me after I got eliminated. So, yeah, with that said, Verx, please do the Venture Twist and bring me back to season 2 and make me a winner, because I truly think I'm a star and I should be winning this lonesome at least one season. Bye, Welcome!
Queens, if you can't love yourself, how the hell are you going to love somebody else? Can I get an amen up in here?
Amen!
Amen, I can.
Now let the music play. This week, you will be writing and performing your own verses to RuPaul's newest song, Hustle That Cat.
Oh my god, we're doing girl groups. I love girl groups.
You say you wanna win it, I wanna see you sweat, put your whole kitty in it. You say you wanna win it, I wanna see you hustle.
Look who's still safe.
What the fuck?
You know, I'm not afraid to never talk to somebody ever again, so...
It's honestly not that serious.
Bye-bye, get booted, on to the next.